Get ready to match the stars. Bill Cullen, Rhett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Janice Pennington, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Friends. Nice. Terrific. Thank you. You're a dandy bunch. And we thank you for tuning in here on Match Game PM. We're going to have a good time here tonight, aren't we?
Yes.
Terrific.
You'll get rid of that suit. We'll have a better shot at it.
What's wrong with this suit?
You look like you're a mortician.
There's nothing wrong with morticians.
It's black chic.
This lady's familiar face comes to you through the courtesy of another companion nighttime show called The Price is Right, and we welcome Janice Pennington.
Thank you.
Nice to have you with us.
Hi,
I'm not doing this in order. I'm throwing our director, Mark Breslow, but what the heck, we win some of
it.
Usually I do the irregulars first, but this time I'm doing the irregulars first. Bill Cullington.
Yes, thank you.
With to tell the truth, another nighttime endeavor, and we welcome him. Now.
Rhett Summerton here.
May I say something?
Yes.
America, I don't want you to think that he's unnerved or over-titillated by the presence of the lady in our lower tier. That's only club soda.
Club soda. It's very good. I was thirsty. Thank you. Okay. There.
First you were thirsty, now you're drunk.
No, I'm not. And this is
Why
Charles
did she get
Nelson.
The club soda all the way from Russia? That's what I
Charles Nelson Rillington. And Richard Dossington.
Fanny Flaggington.
Fanny Flaggington.
No, Rhonda Fleming.
Rhonda Fleming.
Yes,
I knew I saw you somewhere. Okay, now what do you say we say hello to our two players here, Mary Schlinkert and Rob King? Hello there. I want to find out a little bit about each of you, and we'll begin with you, sir. Rob.
I was born in St. Louis, Missouri.
Yep.
In 1904. And that was when they had the first Ferris wheel.
Yeah.
And my mother and father was on it, and the thing broke, and they were stuck up there, and that's where I was born. I'm seven.
Now wait a minute, Rob.
That's
you're putting
fact.
Me on.
Well, I was real young, and I don't remember it, but
yeah,
my mother
course,
told
man.
Me that. That's all I know. And I'm 72 years old.
72?
I do the same things that I used to do, or have done all my life, except I don't do them quite as frequent.
I see. You know. Well, Rob?
You've come to the right place.
I know it.
Rob's the original hippie, isn't he? Doesn't that look great? That is beautiful, whatever it
That's
is.
It's a Aztec calendar, a good luck charm. Aztec Indian.
Oh, you frightened me there for a second. Aztec calendar.
Yes.
Well, good luck to you.
Thank you.
Now, we'll find out about Mary Schlinkert, where she's from and all that sort of thing.
Well, I'm single, and I live in New York City, where I'm studying to be an actress.
Really?
And I work as a waitress at night to pay the bills and whatever else. And I'm just here to have a good time.
Well, you're going to have a good time
I
here,
sure
Mary.
Am.
And we wish you the
yes.
very best of luck
Thank
here and also
much.
In your acting
Thank
endeavors.
You.
May I point out to both of you that you'll be trying to match as many of our celebrities as you can, and the winner will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $10,000.
Yikes!
You have something else to say, Rob? Hold it. Rob has something else to say. What is that?
I would like to say for the past 2 years, you people have all been in my house 5 days a week and at nighttime, and I just thought it'd be nice to come down and spend a half an hour with you.
How nice. Oh welcome. Wow. Good. Okay, Rob. Ask you to make a selection. Do you
B.
want A? Yes.
B.
B it is. Rob King wants B. Here it is. The tattoo artist said to Frank, for $200... I'll tattoo your chest with a picture of Raquel Welch. For $2, you get a picture of blank. For $200, I'll tattoo your chest with a picture of Raquel Welch. For $2, you get a picture of blank. All right.
Hold it.
Just think about it now.
Yeah.
Remember, you're trying to match Rob King. That's there. True. That's the object of the game.
Just want to make sure everybody's doing...
Hmm.
Oh.
Okay. Now, here we go over here to Rob King. Everybody's light is on. Rob, the tattoo artist said to Frank, for $200, I'll tattoo your chest with a picture of Raquel Welch. For $2, you get a picture of blank.
Your wife.
Your wife.
Yeah.
You got the idea. No, that's a good answer. $200 for Raquel Welch, $2 for your wife. What's wrong with that? What do you say, Bill? Hello, Bill.
$2 never did it for me, Gene. That's all I know. No, I figured this is a conceited tattoo artist, and for $2, he said I'll do a picture of me.
Of you?
Yes, thank you, and I'm sorry.
$200 for Raquel, $2 for you. What do you say, Brett?
Well, I said for $2, you got a cute little picture of a hooker from Steubenville, PA.
Okay. I'm sure Rob would have thought of that if
well, you didn't need the bottom part. That was just a little added.
Charles,
levity.
What do you say there?
I think Rob still feels on top of that Ferris wheel. I said Brett.
What?
Thank you, James.
Janice?
I hope your play's a flop.
Rob says for $2 you get a picture of your wife. What do you say?
I don't know where I came up with this answer, but I said olive oil.
Olive oil. She was not your most handsome lady, was she?
Well, it isn't handsome or pretty. That's not what he's working on. With Raquel, because she's so voluptuous, he would use a lot of time and
effort. Oh, I see. A lot of ink.
Right. So for $2, he'll do twigging.
Oh.
Just a straight line. Down the
right. That was a direction I hadn't gone, uh-huh. I thought of there. Now, Fanny, we come to you.
Hi.
In love with Rob, by the way.
She is in love with Rob.
I was in love with Yul Brynner, and I took one look at you, and I'm on the same wavelength.
There you go.
Oh, there it is. There's one for you, Rob. You return her affection, no doubt. Now, Mary Schlinkert, this is all yours. Old man Periwinkle said to a 17-year-old bride...
He said, on a honeymoon, you can do anything you want to do. But remember, whatever you do, do it blank.
On your honeymoon, you can do anything you want to, but remember,
whatever you do,
do it blank. I think I got
that
one.
Who did he say that to?
His wife.
His bride.
Well, I can't hear with an accent like that, and that voice is so low.
Quiet.
You know I have trouble.
Quiet, I said quiet. When I say quiet, I mean quiet.
Since the war.
Old man Periwinkle said to his 17-year-old bride, on her honeymoon, you can do anything you want to do, but remember, whatever you do, do it blank.
Hi. Hello there.
Ready.
Very good, Steve.
Ready, here we go. All right, Mary, old man Periwinkle said to his 17-year-old bride. on our honeymoon, you can do anything you want to do, but remember, whatever you do, do it blank.
Gently,
that's good.
No, huh?
You don't know, old man Periwinkle. Okay,
here we go. She said gently. What do you say?
Well, the way you did him, he sounded awfully old.
Yes, he's very old.
So he said, whatever you do, do it alone.
Well, shall we press on, Brett?
I last weekend met this really nice person. He was in the Marines, had a little hat, and I said, whatever you do, do it slowly.
Slowly? That was the idea you had, but you didn't come up with the right word, Mary. Gently. What's wrong?
You're a disgrace to the industry.
It came off the set. Did they paint this?
Well, it's not paint. It was just dust.
Oh, dust.
Yeah.
Your suit is molting. Wait a minute. What'd you do with the question? No tricks.
No, it's very difficult.
Hello there.
Guard!
What do you say?
Slowly!
Slowly! Oh, all right. Mary Slinkard is looking for the answer. Whatever you do, remember, whatever you do, do it gently, she said.
Do it slowly. Yeah.
Okay.
Now, I'm going to appeal to the judges because I meant this.
Yeah.
Listen, and I think you'll see it. I said, carefully.
Carefully.
Gently?
Hey. Yeah. Oh.
Star is born.
1-1.
Thank you, judges.
All right, Fanny. She's looking for gently.
Yes.
And whatever you do, do it gently. Come on now.
I thought that he would say, whatever you do, do it first.
You know, it's really surprising with six sophisticated people as we had here. No one said,
whatever you do, do it fast.
I would say do it with someone else.
Well, okay. We all drew our own personal experiences,
that's
dear.
Right. No, quiet. 1-1 the score, and that's the end of round one. We got a tie here. Round two coming up in a moment or so, but first this. Okay. Now, he went first last time, Mary. So we'll ask you to go first this time. What do you say, A or B?
B, please.
B it is. Everybody plays except Richard. The absent-minded plumber made a terrible mistake. He put his toothbrush in his toolbox, and he brushed his teeth with his blank. All right.
Who does Mary study with in New York?
She didn't say. Who does Mary study with in New York?
The American Academy of Dramatic Arts.
Oh, the American Academy of Dramatic Arts.
Oh, good gravy,
Many
Marie.
Distinguished...
I almost went there myself.
No kidding.
Changed my mind at the last minute.
It was founded 30 years later.
Do you have an answer?
Can you imagine? I was all the time. I forgot to put
there
it in.
There we go. Everything's in its place now and Mary. The absent-minded plumber made a terrible mistake. He put his toothbrush in his toolbox and he brushed his teeth with his blank.
Wrench?
Wrench. Now wrench is good. Now wait a minute. Who is on? What's your answer? Drano. You'll never be on this stage with a dumb answer like that. Drano. Really? That's the worst answer I've ever heard. What do you say, Bill?
That's a gargle.
That's a gargle, yeah.
No, if he was that absent-minded, it's a pretty picture. He brushed his teeth with a plunger.
A plunger. Yes. Okay. She's looking for a wrench, Brett.
Oh, we're all looking for a wrench in one way or another. I'll just settle for a little pinch. No, he went like this. Then he used his little... plunger.
The plunger. So that's two plungers, but she still wants a wrench, Charles.
Then I'll give the chick a wrench.
Okay. Oh,
I love
one wrench
you.
To Mary Slinkard. Put his toothbrush in his toolbox, brushed his teeth with his wrench.
With his wrench.
Oh, there it is. Mary. Now, Fanny, you're up next.
Plunging along to disaster. Plunger.
Plunger. So, you're up to 3, and now, as we go to Rob King, I point out to you, Rob, you need 2 to tie and 3 to win. Do you understand?
I understand.
Good. At the party, Susan said to Sally, "Hey, you must really be drunk. That's my nose you're blanking."
Got it!
Got it. At the party, Susan said to Sally, "Hey, you must really be drunk. That's my nose you're blanking."
Oh, Fanny does it right because she got it right
Fanny
the first
time. Fanny does it right because she matched Rob in the first round. Okay, good. All right. All set. Everybody ready over there? Hello, Rob King. At the party, Susan said to Sally, "Hey, you must really be drunk. That's my nose you're blanking."
Powdering.
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 Wow. Oh, Rob.
Do a man in a Ferris wheel. Yeah, no,
all right.
No class, Rob.
Powdering is his response. And yours, sir?
He blew it.
He blew it? Blowing and powdering, I suppose, are the two good ones, and he chose powdering.
I'd say blowing.
You say blowing. My nose is blowing. Did blowing cross your mind?
No.
No. No. Okay, that's an honest response. What do you say?
I'm trying to kid you.
I say I'm crazy about Robin. I wish I'd said powdering. I said blowing.
So we're looking for powdering.
There she blows again.
There she is. That's three blows, Rob. And you're looking for powdering. And Janice has...
Blowing.
Now, you've got to... That's me. It's Mary Schlicker. What do you have?
Like Mary Schlicker.
We hang around here for a minute or so while we talk to Rob. Rob, may I shake your hand? You're a splendid... You don't have to stand up just because I'm a star. Sit down, Rob, there.
It's good being here, and I'll be looking for you Monday morning.
Well, I'll be very happy to have you among there, and I'll be thinking about you. Rob King, we've got some gifts for you. What do you think? So long, Rob. Now, while he's spinning off, we've got a couple of messages we want to spin for you. Congratulations. Here we go now, my dear. It's time for the Big Money Supermatch, where you can win over $10,000. Now, to do that, we have two audience matches for you. And I want to point out to you, whatever you win in these audience matches, you'll have a chance to multiply by 10, and that's the amount you'll be playing for. Here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, Mary, and we got their best response to this. Blank. Bones. Now, the answer that bunch gave most frequently is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the middle answer, the answer they gave second most frequently, you get $250, and the third gets you $100. And you can get a little assist here from our brilliant celebrities.
Well, every time at home, I always match Richard, so I have to go with him first.
Oh. Well, I'll come to your house and we'll match. Them bones, them dry bones.
Dry bones.
Yes.
Dry bones, a great old song.
Brett Summers, please.
What do you say, Brett?
What about Skin and Bones? It's what I've always wanted to be.
Yes. As Mary is here.
Yes.
We're going to send her to camp this summer and see what we can do about it. Well, anyway, go ahead.
Charles, please.
That law firm, Skull and Cross.
Mm-hmm. Skull and Crossbones. Okay.
Like so
those are the three you
bones.
Have. Skull and Crossbones, Dry Bones, and Skin and Bones. Now, have you thought of anything else, or does one of those appeal to you?
No, I matched Richard, so I'll say Dry Bones.
Dry Bones.
What is Dry Bones?
You don't like it? What do you think? Lazy bones?
Lazy bones.
Boy, that? Chicken bones.
Chicken bones.
Dog bones. Boy, there are a lot of them here. I don't know. My mind's in a whirl now. I don't know what we're doing here. Let's find out if Dry Bones is under the $100 response. Dry Bones it is. Congratulations, you got the $100. Okay. Let's see the 250 number, Earl. Skinny bones.
There you go.
Okay, that would have been close to skin end. And the last one, the $500. Lazy bones. Okay.
I don't know, we're out of touch.
You're so good, audience. We are going to divide a ham sandwich among you. I don't know. Anyway, you've won $100, which means that the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $1,000. Now we're going to see how much more money you can win. We polled another studio audience and got their response to this. Mason Blank. All right. Now, whom do you call it?
Richard again.
Mason... Who's that horrible little kid? What's his name?
Reese.
Who? Mason Reese. Yeah, deviled ham devil.
Yes.
That's the kid, anyway.
You just ruined the whole career.
Fanny, please.
Mason Jar!
Oh.
Jar! Mason Jar.
Okay.
Brett?
Mason Dixon Line!
Mason Jar, and Mason Reese.
I gotta go with the audience, Mason Dixon Line.
Are you leading her astray? No? Well, now, wait a minute. They were right last time. Let's see if they're right this time. May we see the $100 response? Mason Reese.
There's the little devil.
Yeah, get him. Little rascal.
He's so small, he'd have to be at the bottom.
Mason Dixon Line, is it under the $250 number? Mason Jar.
Hello?
All right, last chance for Mason Dixon Line. Slide it, Earl. Yeah! Congratulations. Now, this time you've won $500. We multiply that by 10, which makes $5,000. Add that to the $1,000 you won in the first audience match. Gives you a pot of $6,000 to shoot for. Now, to collect that, there's a little catch. You got to match one celebrity exactly, head to head, and it's time for you to choose one.
Richard, please.
Okay, Richard. Stand on the adhesive tape there. And face it, Mecca. And there it is. Here it is. Worth $6,000. Motion blank. M-O-T-I-O-N. Motion blank. Okay. Mary, he's finished, and we ask you to give us an answer which you think will match his. Motion blank.
The only thing I thought of was motion sickness.
You know, listen, that's the only thing I could think of. I was sitting here, what would I say? Motion sickness. That's all I could think of. Well, let's, we hope, motion picture. Uh-oh.
Motion picture.
Someone just said that in the audience. Well, let's find out right now if you collect the $6,000. Richard?
Where are we, Don?
We're in Hollywood.
Capital of the world.
Motion picture capital of the world. It's funny, I drew a blank on that one, too. Motion sickness.
You're an actress.
And being an actress.
I don't know where my mind was.
Well, anyway, you've got your $600, and we thank you for being with us. And now we're going to do a little business with America. Come right back. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next week for Match Game PM. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive cool comfort from Frederick, leader in energy. Efficient room air conditioners. Frederick lasts for years. Saves you a lot of money. And Record a Call 80, automatic telephone answering system. Voice actuated with a remote control that plays back your message from anywhere in the world. And Proctor Silex's Counter Magic Toaster Oven, a two-tray toaster oven that also broils and pops up toast. Another superior design from Proctor Silex. And a beautifying for deck car upholstery and vinyl tops. Use Raleigh Vinyl Care products from DuPont. And for a smooth-running car, Castrol GTX Motor Oil for all models and sizes of cars. Castrol lubrication for cars, motorcycles, and snowmobiles. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.